Nigel, you're a long-time regular critic of the European Commission. Mm. Were you pleased to hear what the Commissioner was saying here?
Well, he understands it. He understands that it's not the hedge funds, it's not short-selling that's caused this mess. What's caused this mess is, and there's a great myth, we read in the newspapers every day that since the 1980s we've deregulated financial services. Actually, the last 10 years of my life in financial services were a daily misery because of the mass, the blizzard of regulations that were being put on it. What we did, we've got rid of some of the basic sound rules that we used to have. For example, banks were not allowed to lend more than 80% of the value of a house to somebody taking out a mortgage. Banks did not lend more than 3.5 times people's salary on a mortgage. And in America, we had a piece of legislation from 1931 that meant that investment banking and retail banking were kept entirely separate. So what we've done, what governments have done, is they've taken away what were some very good, sensible rules, replaced it with a mass of legislation which is meaningless. And I think McCreevy understands that, and I think his instincts are right.
And what about the instincts of your colleagues in the Parliament who voted?
Well, I mean, Mr. Rasmussen, whose report was voted on this week and has been passed, demanding that we legislate. Mr. Rasmussen said to me last year that he hated the City of London, he didn't like our Anglo-Saxon way of doing business and wanted to do something about it. And my great fear is that we put in place more of the wrong kind of legislation and we send our financial services industry to Zurich and Bermuda and elsewhere. And I really am concerned about that.
And that's
thinking about how we regulate financial markets. And you talked about since 2000 the creation of a single market in financial services, and we've had this mass of regulations as if this was all brand new. It isn't brand new. You know, we used to have a Bank of England that used to regulate our banking sector, stuffed with people who were genuine experts in the field and who really knew what was going on, and we've taken away from them real responsibility for managing the banking sector, and we've handed it to a group of civil servants who interpret European Union directives. We had better regulation in financial services 20 years ago than we've got
to now.
It has everything to do with EU regulation because it takes precedent over national
law. When you build it up the FSA, it was because the previous system didn't work. And you thought you would become more clever with the FSA.
Well, it hasn't worked.
And one of the elements of this crisis might be that the regulation system in the UK needs to be reviewed. But I think if you were already at that stage...
The FSA is a branch office
financial
of the European
Services
Commission.
Authority.
All financial services regulations comes from the European Union.
Herr Vosch, why
That's
do we
fact.
Need... I mean, given that the sort of the market is so concentrated in the UK, why do we need EU legislation on this anyway? I mean, the Financial Services Authority is looking...
This is the critical issue. This crisis... We are learning with this crisis that you cannot just split financial markets and the current situation of people in the day-to-day life. It has an impact. When financial markets are going crazy like they are going now, it has an impact on growth and job for every day, for every citizen. So there's a link between the activity of what's going on in London and the level of activity for the whole EU. So UK in financial market is not an island. It's not an island.
I don't think it's enough for Nigel and others to paint the picture of Europe wanting to do in London. That's not true. The global network of financial services which exists around the whole of the world, the whole of the world is actually now in crisis.
Nigel, how can you say that? Sorry, can I just interject just briefly? I mean, how can you say that when you hear the Commissioner... for the single market, saying to the Parliament, lay off.
I agree with a lot of what McCreevy said in that clip, and I think he understands things, but McCreevy is a very isolated figure. I predict that within a year we will have a mass of financial regulation. We will try and regulate hedge funds. We will put a new mass of directives on London's financial services industry, and we will see people going to Bermuda and Zurich.
It's not the view of the biggest group of the European Parliament.
To find out more about who we are and what we stand for, go to the UK Independence Party website at www.ukip.org.